Good evening, everyone. I'm Dr. Nivedita, and I'm going to present my topic of 3D printing. As you, for more than in the field of engineering, healthcare, and industry, and the first 3D printer was patented by Charles W. Hull in 1984. But from then, it didn't come into forensic field, and only recently they have introduced 3D printing in the field of forensics for investigative procedures, and it has changed the way investigation takes place. So the three skulls in the poster represents the process of 3D printing. The lower left one is the original evidence, which is scanned by the 3D scanner, and then the image acquired or the data acquired is then printed into a 3D model, which is used for the evaluation purpose. So let's see about the main advantages and limitations of 3D printing. The first or primary advantage of 3D printing is that it creates an accurate physical replication of the original evidence. The second one is it is used for documentation purposes or storage purposes, because human remains can get degraded very easily, while 3D printed model can stay for a longer period of time. The third one is it can be easily transferred due to its digitization. From one forensic scientist to another scientist, it can be easily transferred. And the fourth one is it can be useful in courtroom demonstrations when human remains or the ethical considerations for human remains is very crucial. So while a model can be used in that cases, then we all know that 3D printing has been used in forensic facial reconstruction for recent years. And then 3D printing has a very good quality, which is that you can use it for re-evaluation purposes or for recreating the old evidence. Like it can be many number of copies can be made from single scanning. Then it can be used for education or training purposes for the forensic science students and forensic scientists. And the last one is it can be researched. That is, it can either be scaled up or scaled down according to the need. Well, like for example, a smaller size evidence can be enlarged and it can be produced, it can be printed for surface details. So that is how it can be resized. So let's see about the limitations of 3D printing. 3D printing has quite few limitations. For example, when the original evidence is very fragile, like a charred body or charred remains, it can, the scanner cannot be, will not be able to scan it properly. So there might be a loss of surface details, which can result in a faulty 3D model. Then the same thing, when the material or the technique used can also impact the model created. For example, in SLS or powder-based method, when powder-based technique, the surface may get granular or it may be very brittle. So that is also another limitation of 3D printing. The third one is that validation of 3D printing in forensic field has yet to be explored. So due to that, it may create risk in bias in the courtroom. That is, it cannot be used as a validated evidence to produce in a courtroom. Then due to its digitization, it has many confidentiality issues and privacy issues due to data sharing and due to cyber security threats. Cyber threats are increasing nowadays. So there are many number of confidentiality issues in 3D printing. And the last one is it can only be used as a complementary evidence along with a CT scan or any other radiograph, and it cannot be used as a single, like it cannot replace the original evidence. Though it has very high advantages, the main advantage is it can be only produced as a complementary evidence. And thank you very much.